to kick off for Denver.
The final weekend of the summer. Hope you're enjoying it wherever you are as we are off and running on EA Sports. And as we see so frequently here in Colorado, that one over the end line. So it'll come out to the 25. Throwing on first down is Brady. This into the hands of his running back, Ronald Jones. And he's going to be taken down right at the line. Nothing on that one. It'll be second down.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. Had the completed pass, but for no gain, stopped right at the line, so it's second and 10. Here's Ronald Jones, first carry for the USC man. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
And he's got this almost to the 40 before going out. It's a game 10 yards there and a Buccaneer first down. Tampa Bay. Brady gives this one off to Jones. He'll get about 3 as he's brought down right around the 42.
That's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play. It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
Here's a throw out wide complete to his running back right side. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line.
I like the screen being called here early in the game, especially on the opening drive, because, Brandon, when guys come out of the locker room, especially those pass rushers, they are so amped up to get to the quarterback that you can use that against them, and a screen pass is a great way of doing it. A lot of teams against good pass rushing teams, they want to run the screen 10 to 12 times in a game.
Two first downs have him up near midfield now on first and 10. Throwing now is Brady. He completes this into the hands of Miller. The completion, but they go in the wrong direction. A loss of yards, and now they're dealing with a second and long. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. So they had the big loss on that first down pass play and facing a second and long. From the gun, it's Brady. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
Brandon, we saw these defenders flying to the football in their win last week, and nothing has changed. They're still moving around quickly and forcing incompletions.
On third and long, it's Brady. Open man is Howard, the tight end. And he's going to come up a few yards short. Brought down at the 45. They'll get 11, but it'll still lead to a fourth down. Brady to throw for it on fourth down. It's caught. Jones. And he'll be touched down here, but not before he does pick up the first. It's a game. Well, we kind of looked at each other as they decided to go for it, but in the end, great execution, a 6-yard gain, and it all works out. Now a first down carry by Jones. And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
On second and 11 now. Brady toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete. The Pro Bowler Chris Godwin, the intended receiver. And now it's third down.
Receiver coaches preach to their guys all the time, separation. That's what's going to make the play successful. That time there was very little, and I think they were actually fortunate that it was only knocked away and not intercepted.
Throwing is Brady on third down. Caught on the right side by Jones. And he'll be taken down well before the first at about the 36-yard line. He did his best to just get four out of that, but not enough. And now fourth down. That's to his running back, complete. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. A big pickup of 12 yards on fourth down to keep this drive from stalling. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. They'll run it with Jones. And not much. Maybe a yard down to the 23. The ball carrier.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. Now Brady. He'll set up the screen to Fournette. And so far, a very nice, methodical opening drive.
This has the feel of a scripted drive that they rehearsed perfectly all week long, and now they're executing it on game day.
Script looks good so far. A nickel set defensively for the Broncos here on third down. They'll try and run for it with Jones. And he'll have the first down, getting this one to the 14-yard line. Give him 2 yards on that play. And this long drive is going to continue as they move the chains again. Quick pass out to Miller. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Buccaneers.
Tampa Bay.
Scotty Miller, his second touchdown on the season. And the Bucs take the ball down the field and score on their opening drive. And that one gives the Bucs a 7-0 lead.
Makes the score Buccaneers 7, Broncos nothing.
Now Pinion with the kickoff honors following the touchdown. And a short kick taken at about the 16. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25.
At their own 26-yard line.
Lock and the Broncos going to come up first and 10 at their own 26. He'll throw from the gun. Flush to his right. Open man, that's Noah Fant, the tight end. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. A big gainer there on the catch and run, 37 yards. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Shotgun snap to Lock. There goes a deep ball, end zone. Oh, he had 6 points in his hands there, couldn't hang on. Second down.
Incomplete.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
Back to the air on second down. It's Locke. This one into the hands of the running back, Ballage. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a 3rd and 8 coming up. Throwing is Locke on third down. He's got a first down and much more inside the 20. And he will have a Broncos first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. 18 big yards on that one and a Denver first.
First and 10 at the 16-yard line.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. Now the former fourth-round pick, it's Kalen Ballage.
advantage.
And effective running here. He'll take it down inside the 10. 9 yards is the pick up there, and they'll have a second and one. Now Balazs, and he'll take it into the end zone for a Denver score.
Touchdown.
Kalen Balazs, his second touchdown on the season. And the Broncos are an extra point away from tying the football game. On here, Brandon McManus for the point after. And the kick makes it through, but flags come flying in as well. It appears we're going to get a roughing call tacked on. Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post, because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Brady and the Bucks now with a first and 10 at their 25-yard line. He fakes the give here and looks to throw. Sliding out of the pocket. And he finds Howard complete. He'll be dropped after a gain of about 6 across the 30 to the 31. A gain of 6 there on first. Brady going to fake the give to Jones and set up to throw. He'll find Miller. That's complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
I know this may be jumping the gun a little bit, but 7-7, they're flinging it around like crazy. Look at the drive that's going on here. Partner, we may have to start thinking about one of these defenses just holding someone to a field goal and maybe trying to get an advantage that way.
Wait, that's...
On first down, Brady. And now a fumble. Brady loses the football. It's picked up by the Broncos. And they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line. He was under duress, surveying, trying to find somebody to get the ball out of his hands. In the meantime, the defense, they took it out of his hands.
And when the ball snapped, I know exactly what the defense is thinking. Get a sack, put him on the ground. But when you can also knock the ball free while doing so, oh, there's the bonus for you as a defender.
This is the tight end Fan. And they're able to get this one past the 30, down to the 25. That one going for a gain of 11 and a Bronco first down.
5-yard line.
From the gun, it's Locke. He's got his big tight end, Fan, and he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. Give him back-to-back catches now. That one for 16, and another first down.
First and goal at the 9-yard line.
These two teams all tied after one.
With the score tied 7-7.
Fights loose. And they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 9. It'll go as a loss on the play. Not what you need down here. It's going to be second and goal. Now from the 9, here's second and goal.
At the 9-yard line.
Watch the safety creep.
Again, it's Locke. Eluding the pressure right. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. He was trying to find Noah Fant, the tight end, but now it's third and goal.
That was an interesting look there, because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them, and I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
Blocked now on third and goal. Flushed out right. The Bucs defense stiffens and pushes this to fourth down.
They certainly had good starting field position on that drive, but couldn't do anything with it after 3 plays. Have to admit that that's a disappointing end to excellent field position. When that drive started, they had 6 points that they were thinking about.
That drive took him inside the 10. Good job defensively to hold him to 3.
Yeah, I like how you did that. Give a little tip of the cap to the stop troops there, because they didn't give up a touchdown in that situation, right? Made them kick the field goal. And yeah, points went against them, but that feels a whole lot better running off the field.
And no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And last time they coughed it up, led to a field goal. They're fortunate that it only led to a field goal, but still, they're not happy about it.
Could you sense the relief, though, when they only gave up the field goal? And they were able to trot back out on the field and start this drive.
He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Bryce Callahan. And his crew will take over at their own 45-yard line. If you combine last week and this week, he's got a hat trick going because he had 2 interceptions a week ago.
He's seeing the ball so well and understanding where receivers are and positioning. I mean, just watching him work with such great technique and paying it off by actually catching the ball when he has a chance, he's helping his team in a huge way.
They throw right away, and that's complete out on the right side. Given 9 there on the first down completion.
Noah Fant.
Noah Fant was a first-round pick in 2019, and he was picked because of his receiving skills. Had 40 catches in his rookie season for 562 yards. Did have 2 games where he topped 100 yards in each of those. Yes, he's still developing as a blocker, but that's not why he went in the first round. He went there for his ability to make big plays down the field.
15 yards on the play, first down.
31-yard line.
Block working out of the gun. Flush to his right. Completes it to Fant on the right side. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. 15 yards last play and 15 yards here this go around.
First and 10 at the 16-yard line.
Into the red zone, it's Locke. And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
And he's able to get this inside the 10 now to the 9. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
Locke going to try and throw on 3rd down. And it's caught. And he is into the end zone for a Denver touchdown. Courtland Sutton, his 6th touchdown of the season. And the Broncos will add on to their lead. It's good to make it 17-7.
Point is good. Makes the score Broncos 17. Buccaneers 7.
Brandon. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily if you look at your plays, oh, this hurts the defense. I want the ball in the hands of X, Y, and Z and see if we can move forward.
So don't get too cute. Go to the playmakers. They'll contain him to just 4. 2nd down. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. 7 yards there and a 1st down.
Even though they gave up more than they wanted to on that play, it actually illustrates how well they bottled him up throughout the game because that was his longest run of this contest.
On first and 10, here's Brady. There's the Penn State man. It's Chris Godwin. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. 15 yards as Tampa Bay picks up the first. Jones. And he'll snag about 5 yards down to the 32.
That's a really good gain right there. They pick up 5 yards halfway to a first down. The only problem now in the huddle, everyone's going to want to touch the football. Be a lot of chattering now because they've seen that they can move the line of scrimmage.
The first down run got 5. Here's 2nd and 5. This is Jones. And he'll be down close to the first down marker as he gets this to the Broncos 27. It'll go as a gain of 6 that time, and it moves the chains as well.
First down, Tampa Bay.
Now a man coming off a career year in 2019, Leonard Fournette. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. That'll be a pickup of 10 as they try to recover from this 10-point deficit. Into the red zone, it's Brady. Forced out to his left. Now he'll pull it down. It won't be a sack, but it's no gain, and it brings up 2nd down.
Well, there was pressure all around him, so the only play was to try and get out of there. I think it was an excellent effort by him just to get back to the line of scrimmage.
To throw again on 2nd down. Brady to the goal line, but it's incomplete.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap, and he locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
The Bucs on 3rd down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is 3rd and 10. Here's Brady to throw. He sets up the screen to Jones. And they work this near the 5. He'll be stopped at the 6. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal. 1st and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Coming up at halftime, I'll go from one personality, that's you, Charles Davis, to another one in Orlando, the coach. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL. You and Jonathan Coachman, both larger than life.
No doubt about it.
But you're stuck with me in this booth,
yes,
and he's miles away and smiling.
And happy.
One back in the game, that's Jones, 2nd and goal. They'll give it to him up the middle. And he'll get it down close to the goal line, but not quite in. They get 3 yards closer, but still work to do. It's 3rd and goal. Jones, and he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Ronald Jones hitting double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season. And the Bucs are able to make this a close game again. And this is up and good to make it a 17-14 game.
Score, Broncos 17, Buccaneers 14.
And following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. Fielded right around the 8. And able to get this out to the 25.
First and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Mm-hmm. Denver offense at the line, ready to go. And now with still more than a minute to go in what's been a tight game, you figure we'll try to see them move the ball downfield.
And remember, they get the kickoff to start the second half, so this is a golden opportunity for them to go down there and put up a couple of sixes back-to-back. What a momentum swing that would be.
Yeah, you might be able to get a two-for-one without ever even giving up the football.
Second and two at the 33.
Looking to throw again on second down. Locke escaping the pressure right. And this one's incomplete. Cortland Sutton, first-time Pro Bowler. He was the intended target. And it's third and short.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go three and out here and give the football right back, because your friend, Old Momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's going to make the trek to the opposite side, and all of a sudden, you've got a battle on your hands.
He may try and run for this. And he's able to get this to the 40-yard line before he's out of bounds. Big yardage there on the scramble. It gets him a first down.
Certainly making his presence felt in both the pass and the run game. He's having an impact.
Yeah, his first carry of the game right there. He had hurt him with his arm. Now he's showing that he can shuffle the puppies as well. They fake the handoff. Now Locke. Oh, that was dangerous. Locked. Threw it into coverage, almost picked, but instead they'll keep it on second down.
Brings up second and 10 at the 40-yard line.
To throw again, Locke. That's complete, Okwue Buna. They'll cross over out of bounds right at the 25. Good work after the catch, gets him 15 and a first down.
When you get a big tight end like this, sometimes it takes more than one man to bring him down. Oftentimes, your best bet, just jump on and hold on and wait for your teammates to arrive to help get him on the ground.
This will be caught inside the 10. Now the Broncos are going to call the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with just under 30 seconds to go in the first half. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit them, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Now Locke again. They'll roll him out right. And he is into the end zone for a Denver touchdown. A 9-yard touchdown run. And the Broncos will extend their lead.
Well, I'd have to say that for him, that was an all-encompassing drive, because it was his arm that got his team down to that point, but his legs that finished the deal. Give him credit for making it happen.
McManus's point after is good, and his guys will take a 10-point lead. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Bucs take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
The Bucs forced to use their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action. So quickly all the way up at the 40-yard line. Now a play fake, Brady. That's caught by Howard. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. Another first down, this time on a gain of 19. So we reach halftime here in a 10-point game. As we send you on out to our studios in Orlando, here's Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Broncos with a lead, and they will be receiving this kickoff here as quarter three is underway. Taken at the 15, a short kick. And out a little across the 25 to the 27.
At their own 27-yard line.
The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. ball popped in the air and intercepted. Antoine Winfield Jr. picks it, and he's able to get it back to right around the 27. That is just what this defense was hoping for, an interception on the opening possession of this third quarter.
Obviously didn't want to surrender a touchdown and fall even farther behind, and we've gotten to know this team a little bit, haven't we? Couldn't you just see their defensive leaders telling the offensive guys, telling the quarterback, don't worry, we got you to start things off. You take it from there.
And they will not get the connection there. It's incomplete.
I think we can all understand what they're thinking right now. They take over the ball in field goal range after the turnover, so they've got that in their hip pocket. But they've got to go for the end zone and turn this into a bigger point. Their thinking is a touchdown is really what they should get from starting here, getting 3 points.
Now a loose football. The ball comes out, but this will get out of bounds, so possession will stay the same.
Can almost see inside his face mask there the look of relief. He coughed it up, but it goes out of bounds. They keep it.
Someone carried around the lucky horseshoe, aren't they? If I were him, I'd go out and play the lottery after that one. A very fortunate man.
And they're operating in plus territory here. They're thinking points. Definitely don't want to lose the football at this juncture.
The completion, but they go in the wrong direction. A loss of yards, and now they're dealing with a second and long. That pass play wound up for negative yardage, so here's second and 11. Now Jones. And he's able to break out of one tackle, but then quickly brought down. 5 yards on the carry there, and it leaves him with third and about 6 yards to go.
On the play. And it's third down.
They'll go again to Jones. And he'll get this up awfully close to a first down, but by the looks of it, might be a yard shy. He's just short. He got 6 of the 7 he needed, so that leaves a decision here on 4th and a yard. Still just the third quarter, but they've got to make something happen. I think they know that. They're going for it on 4th. They'll go with Jones. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. They only needed a few inches, and they didn't get much more than that. But by about the width of a shoelace, they convert on 4th down. Now Jones. Power on power, but he's not going to get in. No gain on the play, and it's going to be 2nd and goal.
Leads to 2nd and goal.
On 2nd down, it's Jones, and he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown.
Tampa Bay.
Ronald Jones, his 2nd touchdown of the afternoon. And the Bucs capitalize on the short field as they take it in for 6.
Kick is good.
Extra point up and good by Suckup. And that cuts the lead to 3, 24-21.
Bradley Pinion to kick off for Tampa Bay.
Now Pinion with the kickoff honors following the touchdown. K.J. Hamler returning it. And not much happening on the return as he'll get this to about the 23.
The Broncos take over 1st and 10 at their own 23-yard line.
Denver offense at the line ready to go. Their lead down to a field goal now as they start with a 1st and 10. Eluding the pressure right. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. Give him 13 yards on the opening play of the drive and also give him a first down.
36-yard line.
From the gun, Lock. He completes this to Sutton. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up 2nd down.
I know a lot of Denver fans are really excited about the possibilities for Cortland Sutton now that Drew Lock is entrenched as their starting quarterback. Remember, last season, the last 5 games with Lock as the guy in charge, the team went 4-1. I think they'll only get better and better. As for the season, Cortland Sutton had one day.
Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Sean Murphy Bunting. And he'll get it all the way
dragged down inside the 35-yard line. CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape, he's like, ah, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
So after the INT, it's Brady. Quick slant to Brown. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
A gain of 9. Brings
nothing fancy on first down, but a very consistent type of a play. Hit that slant. A lot of people call it an extension of the running game, and it can be if that pass is completed. Because you hit a guy on the run like that, you often can go for big yardage.
Sets him up nicely for second down, staying ahead of schedule. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Give him 14 on that one, and a first down.
Absolutely love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed, and he's able to get to the second level almost before you blink if you give him any type of blocking. Always talk about slot receivers. They're usually known as quicker than fast. In this case, we've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage.
And Brady's throw there, incomplete.
Yeah, that one sailed on him. You've got to make sure you give your receiver a chance to come down inbounds, because they are very gifted. They'll make the circus catches, but they make them out of bounds. That does you no good.
On second down, it's Jones. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on that one as it brings up a 3rd and 10. They've called his number a lot this afternoon. You wonder how much tread is left on those tires.
We certainly do, but I always think back to one of my favorite coaches in the NFL, and he used to have a meeting with his running backs every year in the offseason and say, look, as many times as you're going to carry the ball, you should be able to carry it one more time, so make sure you get in shape.
This into the hands of his running back, Ronald Jones. 3 yards, all they could muster there, and it'll bring up 4th down.
How about that strategy there, Brandon? 3rd down, they just said, we've got faith in our tackles. We'll give you the short stuff, and just decided to protect the sticks. So every time I hear fans telling me tackling's not a part of the game anymore, plays like that, I can clip and save and show them you have to tackle well if you want to be a good defense.
So good kick there to polish off the drive with 3 points.
Yeah, coaches always talk about finishing a drive with a kick. 2 of them give you points, either an extra point or, in this case, a field goal.
Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line.
Take over 1st and 10. At their own 16-yard line.
The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, ah, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. Flushed out right. And he's going to have the hook up to Sutton. And he'll get this to the 30-yard line before crossing over out of bounds. 26 big yards on that one. It's another 1st down. So from Buccaneer territory now, it's 1st and 10 at the 30-yard line. And they'll let the quarterback keep it here on 1st and 10. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 12 more yards there and another 1st down. All right, I got to ask you, with these RPOs, essentially the quarterback has 3 options, right? So what's different from that versus the triple option that we see the service academies run at the college level?
As a general rule, the triple option at the college level, most things are called outside of the quarterback faking it to the runner and then keeping it himself and maybe having a trail back. What I mean is, in the NFL, that option to throw the football all comes about organically. It's a natural deal based on reads. In college, if you're going to throw the football off a triple option, you've actually called that play.
Goal at the 2-yard line.
This will result in him losing yardage. Back to the 3. It'll go as a loss on the play. Not what you need down here. It's going to be second and goal. Welcome back now to Denver. All even as we get ready to start the fourth. Welcome back now to Denver. All even as we get ready to start the fourth. So they're backed up to the 3-yard line, second and goal. Here's a run with Balazs, and he'll take it into the end zone for a Denver score. Kalen Balazs, his second touchdown of the game, his third on the year. And the Broncos have broken the tie. And they will take a 7-point lead now.
Makes the score, Broncos 31, Buccaneers 24.
After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Bucs take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And now, after the touchdown a moment ago, they work from behind in a 7-point game in this fourth quarter. Plenty of time on the clock.
They'll start out on the ground with Jones. And he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
And now this pass brought in by Brown. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. I'll tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. Another good gain. That's now 35 yards combined on those last two plays.
First down, Buccaneers.
The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10. Now Leonard Fournette. Room here to run. And he's going to get this inside the 30. 11 more on that one and another first down.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. I just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there, I'm going to tackle this guy. By the fourth quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down fourth quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down.
First down.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown. From 13 yards out. And the Buccaneers are an extra point away from tying up this football game.
His kick.
CD, it seemed like they were so focused on the guys out wide, they forgot about him out of the backfield.
That's a really good point, because you've got to communicate, and oftentimes when you start counting receivers, that's exactly what you do. You start from the widest receiver, work your way inside. Who gets lost sometimes? The back in the backfield. That's exactly what happened there.
And he got into the end zone.
Take over first and 10 at their own 26-yard line.
Denver offense at the line, ready to go. Well, they just gave up the score to tie it. That's the bad news. The good news, plenty of time in this fourth quarter to try to grab that lead back. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line.
He was tackled
just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
Brings up second and 9.
Shotgun snap to Lock. Got a man open. It's Sutton. Lock 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
That's a gain of 4. Brings up third and 5.
Operating from the gun. Lock.
And this is going to be intercepted. Picked up by Sean Murphy Bunting. And his crew will take over at their own 45-yard line. And so how about that for a momentum switch?
We're in the fourth quarter, and it's a tie game. You've got to take care of the football here. Now their opportunity to take the lead right out the window, and everything is flipped in the other direction.
A throw left side to start the drive is complete. And he goes out of bounds. It looks like right at the 50. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down.
It's a gain of five. Brings up second and five.
From midfield, here's Brady. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains.
They ran that one well. And not only did they pick up a nice chunk of yardage on the screen, they sent a message to the defense. Rush the passer all you want, but you better be careful. We can hit you going back the other direction.
On first down, Jones. Now we've got whistles, and the man slow to get up here is Jones. We'll step aside and get a report when we come back to Denver. They keep it on the ground. This time it's Fournette. And he'll be dropped at the 23 after a pickup of about four.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
It again with Fournette. And Fournette trying to power his way forward, but I don't think he got there. Have to kick this field goal, don't you?
No question about it. Look at the clock. Look at the situation. Kick the field goal.
Ryan Succop on for the field goal. A 40-yard attempt.
And the 11-year veteran bangs it through. And the Bucs take a 3-0 lead. So the drive here ends with a field goal. It does give them the lead, but this one's still certainly a long ways from over.
It definitely puts a lot of pressure on your defense to hold the lead, right? They're happy to have it and happy to be out there trying to do so. But I know as a former player, in the back of their mind, they're thinking, why don't you score the touchdown and seal this thing?
At their own 24-yard line.
The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And they really need to forget about their last timeout, the turnover that led to a field goal. So now they try to regroup, trailing in the final quarter. Obviously, they'd love a touchdown, but three would suffice. And not much to speak of. Call it a one-yard gain up to the 26. They'll get just a yard on the scramble. It's second down.
Brings up second and nine at the 26-yard line.
From the gun, it's Locke. That's going to be caught by Judy. And all the way down to the 24-yard line.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play that picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
So barely time to catch our breath. Here's first and 10 just outside the red zone. They run it with Ballage. And a good run as he manages 7 yards down to the 17.
The ball carrier.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
From the 17, Locke. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Less than two to play with just a field goal separating these two sides. So it's Bronco football as we get you reset here. And now right out of the two-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with a minute 56 to go. And the box with an extra defender in the secondary now on third down.
And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. It's a gain of 5, and now the question, will the offense stay out there on 4th and 1? And he will have the first down before he's tackled at the 12. Just a gain of 3, but they'll certainly take it as they convert on 4th down.
First and 10 at the 12-yard line.
We saw a number of good games earlier today. This one might top all of those. It's been a dandy as we come up on 1st and 10. Flush to his right. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Shaquille Barrett in there to drop him as that clock continues to run. This has been a good march down the field, but now they're stuck looking at a 2nd and 14. To throw is locked.
Open man, he completes it to Judy.
No gain that time on the completion, and it'll be 3rd down. The Bucs going to go ahead and use the 2nd of their timeouts. That'll leave them with just 1 remaining in this 4th quarter of play. Ninth play of the drive coming up, and certainly not an easy one on 3rd and long. Back to throw. He takes it across for the touchdown, and they've taken the lead late in the final minute of the 4th.
Wow, wow. How many people are watching this one right here gave up? Because that score, they might want to try and rush back into this stadium.
Yeah, what looks like is going to be the game-deciding score, although a little bit of time left, so you can't count your chickens before they're hatched.
Well, they better come back in here and watch this one, because you and I, we're not going anywhere. We want to see this one play out.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Bucs take over 1st and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
That's the reason you go for circle round twice for the encore. If you know, you know.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. They can't do much at this point, partner. This one is going to go down in the loss column.
You don't make up for what has happened during the game in this sequence here. Maybe you hand it off and let someone run the ball if you so choose. But otherwise, just kneel down, call it a day, and try and prepare going forward.
Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a 2nd and 5. He's back to throw. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. The Bucs forced to use their 3rd and final timeout, as he'll stop it with 13 seconds left to play. So Brady and the Bucs need to work a little magic. 3rd and long after that last sack. Back to throw, Brady. He's going to let it fly. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
Intended for Tyler Johnson. Incomplete. It's now 4th down.
Down 4 late, got to go for it here on 4th down. One final try now for Brady. That's complete to his receiver, Godwin. And now this is going to depend on the spot. And they say he's just short. So this one will wind up a Denver victory. And they were really helped by their defense, forcing 3 turnovers.
I think what we saw in this one, today's defense. And what I mean by that is, in the old days, pitching shutouts was big time. That was paramount. But the big thing was holding people down, holding down their yardage, right? Don't let them throw the ball through the air and gain a lot of. But now, it's about taking the ball away, taking away possessions, getting the ball back for their offense. They had 3 takeaways in this one, and it led them to victory.
So for Denver, it's an ideal start as they move to 3-0 now on the young season. And they will hit the road next week to take on the New York Jets. Meanwhile,